So I'm here again in Prismic Studios, always with Birkir. In the first video, we talked about what is it like to be a technical director for a studio, and we talked about different topics like the technology and you know, how do you work together as a team, and how do you get these kind of very good results that you're getting. And this video will talk more about dig deeper into the technology part.
Yep.
So. What did you choose? You said that you use React.
Yeah, we are React shop, so we mainly do React.
For building websites.
For building websites and building apps.
Right, and why did you choose React first?
So, yeah, we've gone all around. We used Polymer before. We've used just vanilla JS, and React as a view layer to us is just. It's a good methodology to build components, and
You mean for designers as well, or for developers?
No, for building websites. It's mainly like if you think of
for
think
building
about,
websites.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. If you think about everything is a component. It's a good
it makes
methodology
sense to break pages into components.
Yeah, yeah. Even though like just to use the same kind of structure, like I don't care if it's React or something else, if it's in the same modular way, but React has nailed this, and I think they're here for a very long time.
At least the component approach. I mean, there is
Absolutely.
Vue as well, and they're you know
yes.
they're doing a very good job, but that is the component approach.
Absolutely.
And so what do you win by taking the component approach, by taking something like React? Is it productivity? Is it what? Coherence?
Yeah, productivity, coherence, reusability. I mean, yes. Collaboration as well. I mean, it's
okay,
so
collaboration.
Easy for, yeah, it's so easy for a lot of developers working the same project and there's no collision.
I just
made that component in the sketch file. You can just use it. Oh, okay, yeah.
Oh, nice. Boom. Okay, cool.
So, yeah.
As a teamwork, it helps with teamwork.
Absolutely.
So you don't have cohesion, but you still can share things.
Yeah.
There's a defined way of sharing things.
Absolutely.
And now, did you, so anyone, like whenever you tell anyone, I'm building a page with React, they tell you, oh, SEO and speed, and are you sure you want to use React?
Yeah, absolutely. We get those questions all the time, but the frameworks that we currently use is they take care of all of that. So,
which is
we mainly use Gatsby. That's
Gatsby.
Kind of our go-to system if we want a static site built. So
basically, you when did you start using Gatsby?
That's a good question.
You don't remember?
No, okay. Like we transition into different frameworks quite easily, so because we're very open to technologies, so.
So, for instance, you kind of use Gatsby. You use components, Gatsby like React components in there.
Yeah, I can probably tell you like how we transitioned into Gatsby. So we used to have our own starter kit, and when you have a React code base, you have to have Webpack to build, and you have to have, you know, all the different like CSS modules, and you have to use SCSS, and you can use different NPM packages and so on. So you have to bundle everything together, and then you have to have a server. You have to server-side render the HTML. So we created our own kind of starter kit that we used, and this became unbearable to maintain.
So you made your own Gatsby.
No, yeah, pretty much. But it was more close to Next.js.
Okay.
Yeah, but
it's a good choice as well. Next.js.
Next.js is great as well. We use it sometimes when we need a backend integrated into the website.
Okay.
But we have to connect to different APIs and so on.
So then, when you started doing all of that, you said maybe it makes sense to take something that does all of that.
Absolutely.
Already.
We found a different starter kit that was like actively maintained, and we decided to stick with that and add some layers of technology that we currently use. It was called Starter Kit Universally, and but then later on it stopped being maintained. And at the same time, Gatsby and Next.js popped up.
Appeared, yeah.
And they gained a lot of popularity, and we quite easily join them.
So are you happy with using Gatsby today?
Yeah, very, very happy.
So how is the workflow goes? when you have a page, you have to implement the page. You develop the components. Do you do some queries? What do you use in your queries? What kind of a query language you use?
Yeah. So to begin with, we always add TypeScript. So we have TypeScript types, and then we create the pages. We usually look at the design. Okay, we have maybe 5 to 10 different pages. We have the home page, and then we create the elements page.
Mm-hmm.
And then we go into the components directory and create all the different components that compose a page.
Mm-hmm.
And we add them to the elements page, where we can very easily see all the components that are being made. Because if we have like 5 persons on a team, we may not know who's working on or like who has done what component, because when we slice down the design, some developer may be working on this and some other may be working on this, but they share the same button. And it's just a matter of who's first creating that button.
Oh, yeah, that for that. Yeah.
So, yeah, sometimes it's like that.
And then you use, you told me you use GraphQL.
Yes. So we also, for Gatsby, Gatsby is GraphQL first,
mm-hmm.
and you query all your data with GraphQL, even though it's just local files.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to create a simple block, you could have markdown files, but you query them with GraphQL. But the same goes with if you have to use external services like Prismic or headless WordPress or whatever you want.
Right. So you use GraphQL, you query these things, you push them into the components, the developers will work, the front-end developers will work on different components, and then that's it. That's the page.
Yeah, there's probably one other thing that I forgot to mention is that we often create container components.
Mm-hmm.
Those are components that they query the data, get the data, and pass it down to different component.
Okay.
So they're more like a structural component.
And you told me that when we were talking earlier that you, for each project or most of your projects, you start from scratch. Unlike others maybe would prefer to start from some kind of theme or some kind of scaffold, but you like to start from scratch for every project.
Yes, that's kind of our goal. Like my friend David, he's the ECD in New York, and he likes to go away from the sameness. He thinks every website is getting kind of has the same
look.
It's
unique experience.
So we want to do something new.
And you take that seriously to start from scratch, so that you're sure there's no line of code that is here.
If you have a good base as in, the technology is set up in the right way so we can use them.
Yeah, of course.
We are so quick creating components. And
So you rather invest time into making that good page.
Yes, that's key.
Okay, cool. Well, maybe next video we'll talk more about the CMS choice and how you do that.
Yeah.
Cool. Thanks.
Thank you.